Hey boys and girls, Mike here, One Go Short Play, with the very first of a new playlist entitled Games What I Have Made. This one is Krusty's Super Funhouse. Now, this is the very first game I ever worked on. And I can't remember whether I did the Amiga version or the SNES version. I think I worked on porting the SNES. Oh, crick in my neck. I think I worked on porting the SNES to the Amiga. That said, I'm looking here for the Denton Design logo, because that's the company that did it. I might have it the wrong way around. It might be Amiga to SNES, but I think it is this way around. I think this is the version we work on. Now, it's not a bad game. It's considered a good game. Not a great game. It combines kind of Mario-style platforming with Lemmings, I guess they'd argue. And you'll see why. Okay, here we are in Krusty's house. And what a house. We can only go to one room to get started, so let's do that. I think I pulled down on the doorway. I'll press fire, fire. There's only one button on the Amiga. You know where you stand with that, don't you? Okay. For most games, anyway. I think there's two occasionally. So, up jumps. So, in this one room, we've got four sub-rooms. Four sub-rooms, three sub-rooms. Six, I think. There's three more down there. Let's see what they hold for us. Basically, each one is a puzzle. Out come the rats. Krusty's house is rat-infested. That's the first thing we need to understand. That's a storyline. Pull down on those. Yeah, you collect them. Okay, rats get stuck. Pull down on that. You can see what I've just done. And there's a really badly rendered Bart Simpson that doesn't actually look at all like him. Basically murdering mice, rats. Doesn't make it any less wrong. He's clearly taking pleasure in that method of pest eradication. I'm not sure I agree with the pleasure he's taking. Okay. I don't really like cruelty to animals. That's an understatement. It makes me angry. That room's done. And off we go to the next one. And that's the formula. It's a good game. It's a slow game because every time you play it, you're playing it from scratch. I don't think there's save points in it. I'm not sure it works that way. And of course, if you're playing it from scratch and you know how to do these levels and you've done them already, this one's about wins. See, these things, they don't affect me, but boy, do they affect rats. Check this out. It's just become a bit more complicated. There we go. In they go, and Bart crushes them slowly in his crusher. Yay, let's go to the next one. I think there's also another element to this game. Oh yeah, look, there is. Which is, if I hit them, yeah, burgers. I think that's health. Do I have health? I do, don't I? The other thing you'll see, I've got 10 of down at the bottom there. I can't remember how to use them. Is custard pies. Oh, and a horn. IA push. Oh, you just press fire when you've got them. Fair enough. So, snake, custard pie in the face. Down you go, my friend. Oh, you kick that when you get close to it. Okay. So when you're not close to it, you throw a custard pie. Ow, I'm getting hit. Have that. Oh, that felt good. Even though I don't condone any cruelty to animals, real or virtual. Okay, let's see. This level's a lot bigger than I remember it being. As you can see, not a bad game. It's kind of a cerebral game. It's quite a slow pace. But it's pretty good. Now, my job on this was a tester. I was 14. It was October 93 when they ported this. I think it was like the middle of October. I remember it well. My memories around that era were mainly... That's my cat trying to get in. I'll let her in a minute. Mainly, I'd just been unceremoniously dumped by my first girlfriend of about 20 months and as a kid. 14, I think it was 15 actually. As a kid, I wasn't coping with that very well. And I remember getting this couple of weeks at Denton Design really shook things up for me and helped me focus. on things other than being a lowlife who wasn't worthy of sticking around with in a relationship. So it was kind of nice. Came about at the right time. Basically, my school, Fairfield High School in Widnes, doesn't exist now. It recently got knocked down, made into either a graveyard or a housing estate, I can't remember which. really been to that part of Widnes since back then. But they did this thing when I was a fifth year there, so 15, 16. Work experience for 2 weeks at a local company of some sort, and usually Widnes is known for its chemical industry, so people were working in factories and whatnot. But I really wanted to do art of some sort. Comic art, games art, working in TV maybe, stuff like that. Of course, the school didn't know anyone who could do that sort of thing. And they gave me 2 weeks on a BTEC art course at Holton College, which is the college they kind of fed into. Which is okay, considering it was the best they could do, but it was a bit of a fail, really. I wanted a job, not a course. So I went crying to my mum, who had a friend she used to work with, who happened to have started a games company, and made me contact them and ask them about the job. Well, not a job, a internship, if you like. And I did, and I got one, which was really cool. I got to work with them for 2 weeks, and the first thing I did was this. Basically sat me down in front of this. It was nearly finished, all but finished. In fact, all the games they were doing were very nearly finished. And they basically said, have a play. Oh, don't know how I managed that. I would never have figured that out. Have a play and see if you can find any bugs in it. I think I found a few relatively minor bugs. That's it. And, you know, basically helped make it watertight. So I was quite happy with my work on that. Didn't do any kind of artwork or anything like that. I didn't dare ask. But bearing in mind, it was like my first time in the games industry ever. These people were gods to me. And hang on a sec, that's not working, is it? So we've clearly got to find a second little thing to me, Bob. And yeah, so I was terrified of them and didn't really want to upset anyone by saying, you know, there's something wrong with this game. So I didn't really say much, but I took a piece of paper and basically wrote down bugs, and that was literally how sophisticated that process was there. Works for me to this day. And I'm testing my little games. So a big sheet of bugs as I get toward the end of it. I know some companies I work for get really complex and have, you know, online systems for it all, but it all amounts to the same thing. Just make sure you know what your bugs are. Address your class A's before your class B's and class C's and so on. And that's what they did. Most of the stuff I found would have been class C. There was a class B in the next game I'm going to show you, which I really should have spoken up about, because I feel partly responsible for how bad the game was, and it was bad. There's no two ways about it. The developers will openly admit that, I'm sure. And it's a bit of a shame, because it could have been maybe not great, maybe not as great as its prequel, given clues away here, but it could have been good. If I'd been pushy, or if I'd been the me of now, I believe I could have made that game quite good. But the me of then had no clue how to address a conversation with a professional programmer about how to improve their game. We'll come to that in the next video. But this was the very first game I ever worked on in any way, shape or form. I'm pretty sure it was this version. Krusty's Funhouse, or Krusty's Super Funhouse, depending, I think, on what version you play. In this case, for the Commodore Amiga, the version I worked on might have been the SNES. I guess we'll come to that when I do hit the SNES playlist. But yeah, there it is. Krusty's Funhouse on the Amiga. Thanks for watching.